Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School. It's Hopkinton Hillers softball, as today they take on the 13-0 Norton Lancers. A great pitching matchup on hand for you today. Bree Mirabli on the mound for the Hopkinton Hillers, and for the Norton Lancers, it is Kelly Nelson, the sophomore, who is having a tremendous season. We'll have much more on that throughout the game broadcast. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call, and we are set to go as Alexandra Frontino steps in and takes ball one to start things off. Just underway here on a beautiful day at Hopkinton High School. Rabley deals, and there's a strike. 1-1 on Alexandra Frontino. Rabley and Kelly Nelson, today's pitching matchup at the top of the TVL, and maybe at the top of the state is a strike there. 1-2. And this is hit in the air, a little bloop shot and handled by the second baseman, Emily Whalen. One out in the inning. Let's take a look at the Norton lineup. Alexandra Frontino just flew out to start things off. Taylor Sabati will come up next. Stephanie Noski batting third. She's the third baseman. Sabati stepping in now. She's the center fielder. Carly Arcaro is the cleanup hitter, and she's the catcher. Kelly Nelson, the pitcher, batting fifth. Olivia Peterson, the first baseman, batting sixth. Cassie Phillips, the second baseman, batting seventh. The windup and the pitch. There's a ball. Hitting eighth, the right fielder, Leah Butner. And ninth is Christina Dunn, the left fielder. Wind up and the pitch, and this is hit in the air, a bloop shot in foul territory, and Emily Whalen making a nice catch. Two away. Hillers have drastically improved defensively as the season has gone on, and it's been quick defensive improvements. Very good coaching job by head coach Kylie Murray and assistant Bruce Elliott as this pitch is fouled away. 0-1, a gorgeous day today in the 70s. Has all the makings of a great pitching matchup. Rabley deals. That's outside, 1-1. Rabley on the season has pitched extremely well. As that one's down low. We'll get you the stats on her in a moment. There's a strike, 1-2. Rabley deals, and this is a shot towards the shortstop, and it is handled no problem by Molly Bennett. And just like that, it's a 1-2-3 inning. We head to the bottom of the first. It's a scoreless game between Norton and Hopkinton. Bottom of the first inning, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up for their first time today, as Lily Morningstar will lead things off. As she steps in and is set to face Kelly Nelson, who has had a tremendous season on the mound for Norton. We'll get you the stats on her in just a moment. But she has a stunningly low ERA as that pitch is in there for a strike. And she is just a sophomore for Norton, leading all the TVL and maybe the state. I'd have to do some further research into that. Or one of the, she's definitely one of the top in the state, I can tell you that, because that one's fouled away, 0-2. Kelly Nelson set to deliver. A .17 ERA, 13-0 on the season. That one's fouled away, 0-2. She also has 177 strikeouts. And similar numbers to the Hillers starter last year, Juliet Hume, as that one's down low. But Juliet Hume last year, in 12 appearances, she made 12 appearances on the mound, was out for the first few weeks of the season. Had a .19 ERA, as this is hit up the left side, that'll drop into left field for a base hit. And Morningstar is aboard with a leadoff single. That'll bring up Katie Hawley, the right fielder. But Hume had 124 strikeouts in those 12 appearances and pitched 72 innings. Kelly Nelson has pitched 84 innings. Katie Hawley up now after Morningstar reaches, takes a strike. Let's take a look at the rest of the Hillers' order. Katie Hawley batting second. Molly Bennett batting third, playing shortstop. Kate Wellzell batting fourth behind the plate. There's a swinging strike. Heather Hawley, the designated player, batting fifth. Lindsay Whittles, the left fielder, batting sixth. Bree Mirabli, the pitcher, batting seventh. Isabel Holden, the first baseman, batting eighth. Emily Whalen, the second baseman, batting ninth, as a check swing was not able to hold up. And there's out number one. Emma Murphy's at third base. She's not in the batting order. Molly Bennett will come up to the plate. As far as the Norton field, Carly Arcaro is the catcher. Olivia Peterson at first base. Cassie Phillips at second as this pitch up high. Shortstop, Alexandra Frontino. Third baseman, Stephanie Noski. From left to right, Christina Dunn, Taylor Sabati, and Leah Butler. As that pitch is in there for a strike. And we're going to get a discussion on the mound, as Norton will bring their infield in to talk to Kelly Nelson. And this game is really going to come down to what team keeps their composure, what team will make the first mistake. It could very well come down to that one mistake with the season that these two teams are having and the pitchers that each team has. I'm expecting a pretty low-scoring game here, but obviously time will tell. The Hillers lost to Norton earlier in the season, back in April, 3-0. That was a road game. The sophomore delivers, swinging strike. That'll make it 1-2. 1 on, 1 out. Nelson also having a good season with the bat as that one's fouled away, hitting a 467. As far as Molly Bennett, she's having a pretty good season, 286 at the plate. That pitch up high, checking at first, runner back safe. 2-2. Molly Bennett has also 7 RBIs. And 2 home runs. Does have a little bit of power behind that swing. That pitch up high, 3-2. Bennett working the count nicely. Let's see if she can reach base. Nelson deals. There's strike three, got her looking. Second straight strikeout by Nelson. That'll bring up Kate Wellzell. Kate Wellzell, 281 batting average on the season. 10 RBIs, swinging strike. And last season, Kelly Nelson was the Norton starter. As that pitch down low, she was very good. But this season has certainly taken a step up. 1-1. As this is hit in the air, a little bloop shot right above the head of the first baseman, no problem. And she will be able to make the catch on the little pop out. And that will end the first inning. We will head to the top of the second. It's a scoreless game here in Hillertown. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem, eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. Top half of the second inning as the Norton Lancers will come back up to the plate in a scoreless game, leading things off, Carly Arcaro, the catcher. And she takes strike one. Carly Arcaro, Kelly Nelson, and Olivia Peterson do up this inning for Norton. Wide up and the pitch. Here's strike two. 0-2. Rabley set to deal. Swinging strike. One down. And out, Kelly Nelson to the plate. And Nelson's also having a very good season with the bat as she takes strike one. She's hitting a .467 on the season. And she's hitting all 13 games as she takes a ball there. 14 runs batted in, 12 runs scored. 7 doubles, a triple, and a homer. There's ball two. Two and one. Swinging strike. Nice pitch from Mirabli. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike three. Second straight strikeout for Mirabli. Olivia Peterson will come up to the plate now. And Mirabli is also just having a tremendous season for the Hillers. And she's in the top five in the TVL. As there's strike one to Peterson. As far as Mirabli's stats, a .71 ERA. Is that one just inside? Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. One and two. Rabley set to deal. There's strike three. She strikes out the side. And the game will remain scoreless. The Hillers coming up in the bottom of the second. Bottom of the second, due up for the Hillers. Heather Holly, Lindsay Whittles, and Bree Mirabli. A scoreless game. And a pitcher's duel in the making here. Kelly Nelson on the mound for Norton. Leads all the TVL in just about every statistic pitching-wise. Bree Mirabli, however, not far behind her. As Heather Holly will step in, and she at times could be a huge bat for the Hillers. Hillers 10-3 on the season. Norton 13-0 is that pitch up high. Wind up and the pitch to Holly. She fouls that one away. 1-1. Holly, swinging strike. 1-2. Coming into this week, Heather Holly was at a .500 average as that pitch down low. She only played in 5 of the games, so that's about half the games coming into the week. Bree Mirabli coming into the week was at a point, as that one's fouled away, was at a .71 ERA. As the junior will step back in the box. Nelson set to deal. That pitch upstairs. Two and two. As that one's fouled away, good battle going on here. Nelson set to deal. That pitch down low. Nice job by Holly. She draws the walk. Lindsay Whittles steps in. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. To the set. That one's fouled away. 0-2. Oh, it looks like she got hit by that pitch and then it went off her bat. But now the infield umpire going to say no, and we are going to have a discussion. The two umpires going to get together and talk this one out. All right, so they talked it out and she will go back. The count is 0-2. So the home plate umpire said she was hit, and then the infield umpire says no. Any way we could review the tape, Bob? No. Nelson deals. There's a swinging strike, and she'll take a seat. Unfortunately, we don't have the instant replay capabilities at the moment as Bremer Abley steps in. Pitcher versus pitcher here. That one down low. Wind up and the pitch. Swinging strike, blazed it by her. There's a strike. Checking at first, runner back safe. 1-2. That one's fouled away. Count remains 1-2. Nelson deals. Swinging strike, and Mirabli will take a seat. Second straight strikeout for Nelson, 4 overall. Isabel Holden to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. That one is low. Nelson primarily a fastball pitcher. Rising fastball for strike one. Nice rise through the zone there. Holden steps back in. There's strike two on the inner corner. One on, two outs for the Hillers. Nelson deals, strike three, and she gets all three outs via the strikeout, and it is an absolute pitcher's duel here in Hopkinton. We'll head to the top of the third. It's a scoreless game between Norton and the Hillers. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Weston Nurseries, located at 93 East Main Street. You can find them online at westonnurseries.com. Top of the third inning, a scoreless game between Norton and the Hillers. Cassie Phillips steps in to face Bree Mirabli. Swinging strike. Mirabli with three strikeouts throughout her two innings of work so far. Kelly Nelson with five for Norton. There's a strike two. Phillips steps back in. Wind up and the pitch. Strike three. Three pitches, three strikes, and an out. We'll bring up Leah Butner, the right fielder. Rabley set to deal. There's a strike. Rabley to the set. That's off the bat. That's going to be a foul. 0-2. Butner tried to pull her bat back there, but ended up getting contact with that inner breaking pitch. So far, some pretty good movement on Mirabli's pitches. There's strike three. Two outs in the inning. And now five strikeouts overall for Mirabli as Christina Dunn comes to the plate. She's the left fielder. There's strike one. Mirabli set to deal. There's strike two. Norton is a pretty good hitting team. They're 374 overall as a team hitting-wise. They've scored 101 runs throughout their 13 games. There is strike three. Bree Mirabli feeling it. Two straight innings where she strikes out the side. We will head to the bottom of the third. It's a scoreless game between Norton and Hopkinton. Bottom of the third inning, a scoreless game as the Hillers come back up to the plate to face Kelly Nelson. Emily Whalen will step in for her first time today. And then we go to the top of the order, Lily Morningstar and Katie Holly. Infielders playing in on the corners, aware that Whalen is a bunt risk, a lot of speed. Is that pitch down low, 1-0. And that is very well what this game could come down to. What team can manufacture a run with the way both of these pitchers are throwing today? That's fouled away, 1-1. Norton 13-0 on the season, top team in the TVL. Hillers 10-3, one of the top teams in the TVL. Nelson deals. That is hit in the air. It is in foul territory. Is it playable? No. Arcaro is trying to reach back for it. 1-2. The lefty steps back in. Nelson deals. Strike three. Nelson got Whalen with that high rising fastball, and now Morningstar steps in. Morningstar hit a single as the leadoff hitter in the first. And she'll follow that one away. Morningstar awaits the pitch, the bunt pulled back. One and one. Morningstar at a 318 mark heading into this week. The bunt, and there's strike two. Could not make contact with that one. Nelson deals. Swinging strike, and that'll do it. Out number two, Katie Holly up to the plate. Seven strikeouts for Kelly Nelson. Swinging strike. 0-1. Wind up and the pitch. Swinging strike, 0-2. Nelson deals. Swinging strike, and Nelson strikes out the side in the third inning, and we will head to the top of the fourth. A great pitcher's duel here at Hopkinton High School between Norton and the Hillers. The game is scoreless. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. You can visit them online at goldenpondassistedliving.com. Top of the fourth, Norton back up to the plate. A scoreless game between the Hillers and the Lancers. Mirabli deals. That one up high, 4-1 to Alexandra Frontino, the leadoff hitter and the shortstop. Mirabli deals. Swinging strike. 1-1. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away, 1-2. Rabley deals, there's strike three. Seven strikeouts in the game for Marabli. And that'll bring up Taylor Sabati, the center fielder. Wind up and the pitch, the bunt is going to be down for strike one. Rabley deals. There's a ball, 1-1. Wind up and the pitch. That one down low, 2-1. Rabley to the set, fouled away, 2-2. Rabley set to deliver. On the ground, third base side. Throw over to first is going to get away, and the runner will get second base on the overthrow. So that is an error that allows Sabati to reach. Error on Emma Murphy, the throw a little strong from the third base side. That'll bring up Stephanie Noski. Is that the mistake we talked about? We'll see. And this is hit in the air to right field and is going to drop in for a hit just in front of Katie Hawley. Runner held up at third. It's runners on the corners with one out. And that is a single for Noski. That breaks up the no-hitter. And that'll bring up Carly Arcaro. That one dropped just in front of Hawley. And now Norton with a huge opportunity here in the fourth. Rabley set to deal. There's a strike, runner taking off from first, and they were going to try the double steal, throw back to third, and the runner is just safe. Good awareness by the Hillers defensively. Nice job by Emily Whalen, the second baseman, getting that right over to third. Rabley set to deal. There's a ball, 1-1. Runners on second and third. So Noski does get the stolen bag, but they were able to hold up Sabati. Swinging strike, 1-2. One out in the inning, 2 on. Rabley with a big opportunity here to get the second out. The lefty steps back in. And this is hit in the air. It is a foul ball and out of the reach of anybody into the Hillers dugout. Count remains 1-2. The pitcher, Kelly Nelson, due up on deck. Kelly Nelson could have a huge opportunity to help her own cause here. Rabley deals. And this is popped foul out of play. Rabley delivers. And this is first base side foul. Lefty pulling that one. Rabley to the set. Strike three. Two away. Eight strikeouts for Marabley. That'll bring up Kelly Nelson. A crucial pitcher versus pitcher matchup. Two on, two outs. Upstairs, 1-0. Kelly Nelson, one of the better hitters in this Norton lineup, as well as one of the best pitchers, of course, that pitch up high. Nelson actually leading the team, or second on the team, batting average-wise, behind Stephanie Noski. There's a strike, 2-1. Olivia Peterson would be due up on deck. Shall Kelly Nelson reach? She's also a good hitter at a 378. That one just low, 3-1. Rabley maybe not giving Nelson much here intentionally. She deals. Swinging strike, full count. And you can see Rabley meticulously working the corners here. Fouled away, 3-2. Runners on second and third, two outs, as head coach for the Norton Lancers, Wade Lazotte, will come out and talk to Nelson. Rabley set to deliver. Hit in the air towards the left side, and it's foul. Rabley delivers. Strike three, and she gets out of the jam. The game will remain scoreless as we head to the bottom of the fourth. It's a pitcher's duel between Norton and Hopkinton. Bottom of the fourth inning as Molly Bennett steps in. Nelson delivers. That one is low, 1-0. Nelson set the deal. Swinging strike, 1-1. It was a good job by Mirabli getting out of that jam in the top of the fourth. After an errant throw across the diamond by the third baseman, a breaking pitch there, a lot of movement, but inside. 2-1. Bennett steps back in. Right up in the pitch, swinging strike. Two and two. Nelson deals, fouled away. Nelson delivers, swinging strike, and that'll do it for Bennett. One away, Kate Wilzell to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. Down low, 1-0. Nelson delivers. There's ball two. Nelson to the set, swinging strike, 2-1. Nelson delivers, there's strike two. And this has just been a fun pitching matchup to watch between Bree Mirabli and Kelly Nelson. Two of the best in the state. There's strike three. Two up, two down via the strikeout. Heather Hawley to the plate. Hey, Nelson delivers. Here's a strike. You have to expect that Kelly Nelson has a pretty good career in front of her. She's only a sophomore this year, and already one of the most dominant pitchers in the state. That one down low, 1-1. That one's fouled away, 1-2. Holly walked her last and only time up in this game in the second inning. Nelson delivers. That one's upstairs, 2-2. Looks like she lost her grip on that one. Nelson to the set. On the ground, first base side, and picked up by the first baseman. She'll tag first, and that will do it. A 3 unassisted ground out to end the fourth inning. We'll head to the top of the fifth. It's a scoreless game between Norton and Hopkinton. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. You can visit them online at WebsterFirst.com. Top of the fifth inning, as the Norton Lancers come back up to the plate, Olivia Peterson, the first baseman, lead things off. It's the 6-7 and 8 hitters due up. Olivia Peterson, Cassie Phillips, and Leah Butner. As Mirabli delivers down the first base side, foul. Oh, and one. Rabley set to deal. Ball one, 1-1. Rabley to the set. Swinging strike, 1-2. Rabley deals outside, 2-2. Hillers just played yesterday, and they took a 6-3 game over Medfield. Swinging strike. There's out number one. Rabley has strikeouts for all three outs in the last three innings. 10 overall now as Cassie Phillips steps in. There's strike one. Rabley deals. Down low, 1-1. Rabley delivers upstairs, 2-1. Rabley. And this is a pop up over third base side, handled no problem by Emma Murphy, two away. That's the first out that wasn't a strikeout since the first inning for Norton. That'll bring up Leah Butner. Rabley delivers, fouled away, 0-1. Rabley to the set, upstairs. 1-1. Probably the hottest day of the year so far during the high school spring sports season, as that one's fouled away, 1-2. Temperatures reading at 75 degrees. Hiller's got a little tent in their dugout area as their bench is right in the sun. As there is strike three. And that will do it for the top half of the fifth. Game still scoreless as we sail on to the bottom of the fifth inning. Bottom of the fifth inning, Lindsay Whittles, Bree Mirabli, and Isabel Holden do up for the Hillers. The 6-7 and 8 hitters, swinging strike. The pitcher's duel continues between Bree Mirabli and Kelly Nelson. Nelson delivers, swinging strike 0-2. Ten strikeouts so far for Nelson as Whittle's going to have a word with Coach Murray. And while that happens, the Norton infield will head over to the pitcher's circle. And the scary thing to think of is if you're the rest of the TVL, you're more than likely going to have to deal with Kelly Nelson for another 2 years. As the sophomore delivers, fouled away, got a piece of it. Now a discussion between Carly Arcaro, the catcher, and Kelly Nelson. And now the umpire's talking things over. And they were just making sure that was a foul ball on that last pitch. The lefty steps back in. That's fouled away. Nelson deals, upstairs, 1-2. Umpire saying something to the catcher, not quite sure what. There's strike three. That'll bring up Bree Mirabli with one out. Nelson deals, there's strike one. For those of you just joining us, you're watching two of the best pitchers in the TVL, maybe the state here. As that one's down low, 1-1. Kelly Nelson for the Norton Lancers, Bree Mirabli for the Hillers. Scoreless game in the bottom of the fifth. Swinging strike, 1-2. Kelly Nelson, a .17 ERA on the season. 13-0 on the mound, has started all 13 games. 10 shutouts as there's strike three to Mirabli. 177 strikeouts. And we're going to have a pinch hitter for the Hillers. Maddie Abbott steps in and takes strike one. Pinch hitter for Isabel Holden, strike two. Oh and two, that one down low, 1-2. Perhaps trying to throw more righties in that batting order. That one down low, 2-2. A lot of lefties in the Hillers batting order. Strike three, and Nelson once again strikes out the side, and we will head to the top of the sixth. Hopkinton and Norton are scoreless. Top of the sixth inning, HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Angels Garden Center, located at 65 School Street, growing in Hopkinton since 1957. You can find them online at angelsgardencenter.com. Stepping in for Norton, Christina Dunn, the left fielder. Maddie Abbott now at first base for the Hillers, as that's a strike. In for Isabel Holden. Not quite sure if it was an injury or just a batting order change, perhaps. Rabley set to deliver. The bunt is laid down and foul. One and two. Strike three. So Dunn strikes out. That'll bring up Frontino. Twelve strikeouts for Mirabli. There's a strike. One thing I gotta say about Bree Mirabli is she does perform well for the most part under pressure, as there's strike two. So the pressure of facing a good pitcher in Kelly Nelson, not really phasing her all that much. There's a ball, one and two. To the set, that is fouled away, count remains one and two. Rabley deals, upstairs. Two and two. Rabley to the set, fouled away. As that is hit in the air, foul. Little pop shot over on the third base side. Frontino, a very good hitter for the Lancers. The sophomore hitting a 463 on the season. As there's a ball. She has 10 RBIs, 18 runs, 4 doubles. A lot of good sophomores on this Norton team, as that one's fouled away. Count remains full. Mirabli delivers. There's strike three, two away. 13 strikeouts for Mirabli. Taylor Sabati will come up to the plate. Rabley deals, the bunt is fouled away. Good response by the corner infielders rushing in quickly. And the Hillers, they've certainly practiced for just about every situation. So that one's low, one and one. Rabley deals, and that nearly hit the batter, but she got her foot out of the way of that one. I don't know if I'm the hitter there. I think I'm taking that ball right in the foot. Have to find a way on base. Two and one. Strike two. Two and two. I don't know. The Hillers infield might have thought the inning was over there. Now it is. Bree Mirabli strikes out the side once again. And that is her fourth inning in this game where she got all three outs via the strikeout. We will head to the top or the bottom of the sixth. It's a scoreless game between the Hillers and Norton. Bottom of the sixth inning, due up for the Hillers, Emily Whalen, Lily Morningstar, Katie Hawley, the 9-1 and 2 hitters. Kelly Nelson set to deal. And a running bunt fouled away. Thirteen strikeouts for Nelson in this game. Rabley with 13 of her own as well. Actually, Mirabli, I believe, at 14 now. Running bunt, fouled away. Yep, Mirabli at 14, Nelson at 13. Wind up and the pitch. This is hit in the air, a pop fly above the shortstop, and it's caught. One out in the inning, Lily Morningstar to the plate. Morningstar steps in. The bunt on the ground, up the middle. Throw to first is going to go off the first baseman's glove. Morningstar advances to second. And that is into the Hillers dugout. And she will stay at second. So she reaches on a very, very good slow rolling bunt up the middle. A bit of an errant throw by Kelly Nelson. I'm scoring that the second Hillers hit of the game. I don't think that was quite an error. There's a bad throw over to first, but that was such a good bunt. Hard to argue that's not a hit. As that bunt is strike one. So with one out, runner on second. And we'll get a time from Lily Morningstar so she could tie up her cleat. Katie Hawley with a big opportunity here. And the Hillers, I think they've discovered that they need to just try to manufacture a run. Nelson delivers the bunt, fouled away, 0-2. And they were practicing this prior to the season. Bunting their way around the bases. They ran a lot of drills doing this. And this is a pop fly, third base side out of play. Count remains 0-2, one out, one on. Nelson deals, there's strike three. That's a tough one, that looked low. 14 strikeouts for Kelly Nelson. Molly Bennett steps in. There's a strike. Well, there's definitely a low strike zone, I'll tell you that. That last pitch, I mean, we don't have the best view, obviously, but that looked low. And that pitch just to Bennett now looked low. And there's strike two. Nelson deals, and that is fouled away, and the catcher almost had a good play on it. Arcaro nearly had that one, but it just fell out of her glove. Good attempt by Arcaro. Nelson deals. Upstairs, 1-2. Nelson delivers, strike three. That will do it for the bottom of the six. So despite each team making a mistake, it remains a scoreless game as we head to the top of the seventh. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Dentists at Hopkinton, located at 77 Main Street, providing comprehensive dental care for clients of all ages. You can find them online at hopdent.com. Top of the seventh, scoreless game between the Hillers and Norton. Stephanie Noski steps in to face Bree Mirabli. There's strike one. Mirabli with 14 strikeouts in this game. Her competitor, Kelly Nelson, also with 14, as that one's ripped foul down the third base side. Thank you. Actually, Nelson with 15 strikeouts in this game now. Right up in the pitch. Upstairs, 1-2. Brabley delivers, fouled away. Sun's starting to shy away from the infield. That pitch upstairs, 2-2. That'll certainly help these hitters out a little more. Stephanie Noski having a very good season with the bat, leading the team a 596 batting average, one of the leaders in the TVL as well. This is hit in the left field and handled. Caught by Lindsay Whittles on the little pop fly. One away, Carly Arcaro will come up. Noski is actually the only Norton Lancer with a hit today. She had a single in the fourth inning. Brabley deals. 0-1. Nelson has been on her A game all season, so has Brabley, but Brabley on another planet today as well. Brabley deals. There's a ball, 1-1. And based on divisions, it's not possible, but it would make for a fun playoff matchup if these two teams met up. This is hit in the air, foul out of play, 1-2. Brabley set to deal. That's a ball, 2-2. Wind up and the pitch. Outside, full count. Well, this game could come down to which pitcher tires out first at this point. And this is hit foul. Count remains full. Brabley deals. And this is hit in the air, foul territory. Is it play ball? No. Well, Zell tried to get to it, almost had a play on it, but was unable to pick that one off. Nice dive attempt. The full count pitch, hit in the air, right side, and foul. Brabley set to deal. Up high, there's a walk. It's the first walk of the game from Mirabli. Kelly Nelson will step in. One out, one on. Great hitter and pitcher at the plate. Fouled away. Kelly Nelson at a 467 mark on the season. 14 RBIs. Has scored 12 runs. That one down low, 1-1. Brabley deals. There's strike two. 1-2. Rabley delivers down low. Throw to first. Almost got the runner. She slides back safely. It's Carly Arcaro over at first after she walked. Rabley deals. And this is chopped in the air, left side, out of play, foul. Out of the reach as well as of the left side of the field. Count remains 2-2. Rabley deals. Ball three. Rabley delivers. Strike three. And the throw over to second. The runner slides in just safe. A stolen base on the strikeout. And Coach Murray does not like that call. And it looked like from this angle that she slid just past the tag. And now Coach Murray going to talk to the infield umpire about the call. Olivia Peterson steps in. Two outs, one on. Runner at second, Carly Arcaro, threat to steal. That one's down low, 1-0. Rabley delivers, strike one. Fifteen strikeouts in the game for Rabley. That one outside. The 2-1 pitch. There's strike two. One strike away from getting out of the seventh. There it is, strike three. Rabley with her 16th strikeout, and we will head to the bottom of the seventh. It's a scoreless game between the Hillers and Norton. Bottom of the seventh inning, a scoreless game between the Norton Lancers and the Hopkinton Hillers. What a great pitching matchup we have seen this afternoon as Kate Welzel steps in and awaits the pitch. On the ground, up the middle, gloved by the shortstop, throw to first, one away. Even if you're able to make contact with Kelly Nelson's pitches at this point, it's exciting. Heather Holly will come up to the plate. As this is hit in the air and foul. 0-1 to Heather Holly. Line up and the pitch. Swinging strike, 0-2. To the set. And this is chopped foul. Nelson set to deal. Swinging strike. Out number two. Fifteen strikeouts for Nelson as that's hit foul. 0-1 on Lindsay Whittles. Well, there's, I think a lot of people thought coming into this game, there could be a shot at extra innings. Unless the Hillers get a walk-off or get a run here in the bottom of the seventh, we will see extra innings. Swinging strike. Oh and two on Whittles. There's strike three. To the top of the eighth we go. It's a scoreless game between Norton and Hopkinton. Top of the eighth inning as the Norton Lancers will come back up. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem. Eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. 7-8 and 9 hitters due up for Norton. Cassie Phillips, Leah Butner, and Christina Dunn. As Phillips steps in, and there's strike one. 16 strikeouts for Mirabli. And she is pitching a gem, no matter what the outcome is. There's strike two. Wind up in the pitch, and that is third base side foul. 0 and 2, the count remains. Mirabli delivers. That is hit in the air and foul. Almost caught by a fan. Mirabli deals. That one's foul. Good battle going on here. Well, I think whatever team tires out first, that could be the result of this game. Mirabli deals. Fouled away. Count remains 0 and 2. Mirabli delivers. And this is hit up the middle and handled by the second baseman, Emily Whalen. Good catch, and that'll bring up Leah Butner. Butner 0 for 2, struck out twice. There's strike one. Mirabli deals. In the air, a pop fly. Mirabli handles it. Almost a collision there with Bennett, the shortstop, but she's able to make the catch. That could have been disastrous. And now Christina Dunn will come to the plate. And we got a pinch hitter here for Norton, as there's strike one. And pinch hitting is Jen Karamanica. Strike two. So she'll more than likely take over in left field for Christina Dunn. Mirabli deals down low, one and two. Wind up in the pitch. There's strike three. A great inning by Mirabli. And we will head to the bottom of the eighth. A scoreless game between Norton and Hopkinton. Bottom of the eighth inning. Still scoreless between the Norton Lancers and the Hopkinton Hillers. Kelly Nelson back out there for another inning of work. Two up for the Hillers. The 7-8 and 9 hitters. Bree Mirabli, Isabel Holden, and Emily Whalen. Mirabli will step in, 0 for 2 so far today with two strikeouts. Trying to help her own cause here, take strike one. 15 strikeouts in the game for Nelson. There's a ball. 1-1. Excuse me. That one's fouled away. 1-2. Wind up. And the hold up by the umpire. 1-2. There's strike three. And now batting is Matty Abbott, who took over at third base in the fifth inning. There's ball one. It's her second at bat of the game. And this is hit in the air, foul. Nelson set to deliver. Swinging strike. One and two. Nelson deals. That's fouled away. Count remains 1-2. Heather Hawley getting loose for the Hillers in case she has to come in for Mirabli at some point. There's strike three, two away. But I don't think Mirabli is going out of this game without a fight. Emily Whalen will come up to the plate. Nelson deals. Up the middle, and that'll get through into center field. A single for Whalen. Two outs, runner on. Lily Morningstar to the plate. Time called. There's a catcher calling a time there. Nelson delivers. Upstairs, runner taking off from first, throw to second, not in time. A stolen base by the speedster, Emily Whalen. Runner in scoring position for the Hillers. Line up and the pitch. There's a strike. 1-1. Nelson gets the sign. Upstairs. Nelson definitely taking more time between pitches, even before Whalen was on base. To the set. There's a strike. 2-2. And there's strike three. That'll do it for the eighth inning. To the ninth we go. The game remains scoreless between Norton and Hopkinton. Top of the ninth inning, a scoreless game between Norton and Hopkinton. Top of the order, due up for the Lancers. Alexandra Frontino, the shortstop. Taylor Sabati, the center fielder. Stephanie Noski, the third baseman. Three very good hitters as their strike one. Wind up in the pitch, strike two. 0-2. Oh, upstairs from Mirabli, 1-2. Line up and the pitch, inside. 17 strikeouts in the game for Mirabli. And this is hit in the air to left center. That'll drop in for a base hit. And the leadoff hitter of the ninth aboard for Norton. And now Taylor Sabati will come up to the plate. Sabati had a .344 batting average coming into this game. The bunt fouled away. Oh, and one. Mirabli delivers the bunt, and it is caught! What a catch, and now the throw back to first. The runner slides back safe. Emma Murphy with a dive and a catch. Good thing for Norton that Frontino was able to get back. And now Stephanie Noski to the plate. .596 average coming into this game. Has played in all 13 games of the season. Pulls back the bunt, strike one. Today she is 1-for-3. Mirabli deals. Hit in the air towards center field, ranging over and making the catch for the second out is Lily Morningstar, and the base runner will stay put at first. And the sun mostly out of center and left field, still a little bit in right field, so the sun won't be too much of an issue from here on out. Except in right field, that's where the issue could come into play as the lefty Carly Arcaro steps in. Wind up in the pitch. This is hit in the air, fair territory, ranging over the second baseman and the shortstop. And Whalen, a nice job calling off the shortstop and making the catch for the third out of the top of the ninth. A scoreless game as we head to the bottom of the ninth inning. Bottom of the ninth inning as we are in extras here in Hopkinton, as it has been an absolute sensational pitching battle between Kelly Nelson and Bree Mirabli. The Hillers coming up with another opportunity to walk off with a win if they could play to run. Due up for the Hillers are the second, third, and fourth hitters, Katie Hawley, Molly Bennett, and Kate Welzel, to face Kelly Nelson, who has just been sensational, as she has all season long. As we are set to go, just about, in the bottom of the ninth inning. 19 strikeouts for Nelson. She struck out all three outs in the eighth inning. Line up and the pitch. Bunt fouled away. Nelson deals the bunt in the air and caught by the catcher, Arcaro. One away. Molly Bennett will come up to the plate. Bennett 0-for-3. Struck out twice in this game. Kate Welzel due up on deck. As the righty awaits the pitch. Swinging strike 0-1. Nelson deals. Down low, 1-1. Up high, 2-1. Nelson delivers, and that is fouled away. 2-2. Nelson deals, swinging strike, two outs in the ninth. Kate Wellzell to the plate. There's strike one. Nelson deals, fouled away, 0-2. Nelson delivers, strike three. Scoreless game heading into the 10th inning. Top of the 10th inning, a scoreless game between the Norton Lancers and the Hopkinton Hillers. What an amazing battle. This is certainly has to go down as one of the greatest pitching duels maybe in high school softball history at this point. Kelly Nelson, Olivia Peterson, and Cassie Phillips due up for the Norton Lancers. First pitch in there for a strike, 0-1. It's the fifth, sixth, and seventh hitters for the Norton Lancers. Mirabli set to deal. And this is hit in the air to left field. That'll drop in for a hit. It is a single for Nelson to start things off in the 10th inning. So a runner on. And that will bring up Olivia Peterson. Mirabli deals, swinging strike, 0-1. Nelson has four stolen bases on the season, 4-for-4 overall. Throw down at first, Nelson slides back. The last pitch was a ball. Or excuse me, that was a strike, 0-2. Rabley set to deal. Down low, 1-2. Rabley delivers. There's strike three, one away. That'll bring up Cassie Phillips. Phillips 0-for-3 in the game. Rabley delivers, down low. 1-0. Rabley deals, on the ground, left side, it'll get through for a base hit. That'll put runners on first and second with one out. So Nelson pushes up to second. Phillips at first, one out. Leah Butner to the plate. And it looks like we might have a change here for the Lancers. And we're gonna have a pinch runner. Nicole Granger in the pinch run. Thank you. Leah Butner staying in the game. She'll come up to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Runners on first and second for Norton, one out. She delivers, fouled away, 0-2. I can only imagine how tired both of these pitchers are at this point. Rabley set to deal. That's fouled away. Count remains 0-2. Rabley set to deal. Fouled away. Good battle going on. Rabley delivers. Down low, 1-2. Wide up and the pitch. Hit in the air towards left field, and it is caught for the second out. The runners will stay put. Great job by Lindsay Whittles immediately getting the throw back in to keep Nelson at second and the pinch runner at first, Nicole Granger. And that'll bring up Christina Dunn with two outs. Swinging strike. 0-1. Oh and two. Right up in the pitch, fouled away. Count remains 0-2. And now head coach Wade Lazotte going to talk to his hitter, Christina Dunn. Top of the order due up next, Sheldon Reach. 0-2, two outs, two on. Dunn steps back in, the bunt, fouled away, and that is strike three because she bunted. And that will wrap it up for the 10th inning. Despite the Norton Lancers getting two hits, the game remains scoreless as we head to the bottom of the 10th. Bottom of the 10th inning, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up to the plate. A scoreless game between the Norton Lancers and the Hillers. And for those of you that don't know, a standard game of high school softball is only 7 innings, so we are in our third extra inning here, and this has been a sensational pitcher's duel. And this is up the middle, that'll get through. A base hit to start things off in the bottom of the 10th for Heather Holley. And she's had a decent day for a day against Kelly Nelson, 1-for-3 with a walk, and we're gonna get a pinch runner here. And coming in a pinch run is Katie Sylvester. And now coming up to the plate, Lindsay Whittles. And Coach Murray informing the umpire about the pinch runner. Nice job by Holly, getting on base to start things off. Whittles steps into the batter's box. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away, 0-1. Winning run on base for the Hillers. No outs in the bottom of the 10th. Nelson deals. Fouled away, 0-2. One strikeouts in the game for Kelly Nelson. Pretty unbelievable. Right up and the pitch. Fouled away. Good battle. Count remains 0-2. Katie Sylvester pinch running at first base for Heather Holly. No outs. Lindsay Whittles at the plate. Fouled away. I believe that's the fifth straight foul ball. Nelson deals. Swinging strike, out number one. Nice job by Whittles, though. Got Nelson to throw some pitches. Now Bree Mirabli to the plate. No matter how this game ends, Bree Mirabli and Kelly Nelson pitch sensational. Nelson delivers strike one. 0-1. Despite being in the 10th inning, this game's still just about 2 hours old. It's not a whole lot of time has passed. It's, of course, softball very quick moving when you get these pitcher's duels. 0-2. Fouled away. We did, however, lose our cameraman, Bob Hamilton, to a school committee meeting. So we're keeping the camera going, however. Multitasking at its finest. On the ground, takes a couple hops on the infield dirt. Throw to second, it's dropped, and both runners are safe. First and second with one out. So Mirabli reaches on the error. But she'll take it. Sylvester pushes up to second. And stepping in is Maddie Abbott. We will have time called by the Lancers. They'll huddle up on the mound to talk things over. But two runners on for the Hopkinton Hillers. One out. Hillers a chance to walk off with the victory. Can they do it? Right now you have Maddie Abbott due up for the Hillers. Up next would be Emily Whalen, who had a base hit in the eighth inning against Nelson. As they break up the timeout on the pitcher's circle. Maddie Abbott will step in. The righty awaits the pitch. The bunt, strike one. Wide up and the pitch, strike two. Nelson deals, hit foul. 0-2. And this is hit in the air to left field, and it is caught. Runners will hold up. Two outs. Emily Whalen to the plate. Two outs, two on, bottom of the 10th. Nelson deals, down low. There's strike one. And this is hit in the right field, that'll drop down. Winning run being waved around, third base, the throw in, not in time, and the Hillers win the game. Katie Sylvester comes around to score, and the Hillers win the game, 1-0. Emily Whalen with the game-winning RBI base hit in the bottom of the 10th. What a game between Hopkinton and Norton. An unbelievable win for the Hopkinton Hillers. Final score 1-0. The Hillers had 4 hits in the game. No errors by either team. The Norton Lancers also had 4 hits in the game as well. But Emily Whalen comes through with the game-winning hit. And the Hopkinton Hillers take the victory 1-0 as she's getting nothing but hugs from her teammates for getting the job done. And the Hillers improve to 11-3 on the season. They hand the Norton Lancers their first loss of the year. Norton falling to 13-1. But what a miraculous pitching performance by both pitchers this afternoon. Kelly Nelson with 22 strikeouts, and this is unofficially, of course. Bree Mirabli also racked up a number of her strikeouts of her own. She had 19 Ks in the game, but the Hillers get a win over the best team in the TVL, the Norton Lancers, in what was an absolutely tremendous pitcher's duel. The final score after 10 innings, the Hopkinton Hillers 1, the Norton Lancers 0. For our cameraman, Bob Hamilton, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for joining us for this presentation of Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM. Have a good rest of your day, everybody, and thanks for watching.